I was lucky enough to meet a kid 20-something years ago who was cleaning churches and selling boots. And he wanted to be a demo singer, which is in Nashville, when we write songs, Cory and Nate are great singers, but a lot of songwriters don't sing very good, and so they have to have somebody really good come sing their songs. And so they're called demo singers. So you record a song, and then you get the best singer you can to come in and sing, and it pays pretty well. And so this kid was cleaning churches and selling boots, and he decided he wanted to make more money by singing demos. So he came over to my studio and he brought me a cassette. You remember what cassettes were? Nick doesn't remember, but he played me a cassette and I really liked what he did, and so I started using him on demos, and his name was Garth Brooks, and he didn't have a record deal at the time. You know, I had other demo singers that were singing for me at the time, like this guy named Joe Dippy, and Randy Travis, Billy Dean, and I had this girl that sang all my demos, and she was just incredible. And I kept telling Garth, you need to hear this girl, you need to meet this girl, she's a great singer. And Garth's real loyal to the people that are around, but he's going, oh, I've got a demo singer that I use. And so he didn't have a record deal or anything still then, he was just Garth, and everybody said, oh, he'll never get a record deal with a name like Garth. We kept working on Garth to hear the singer, and he just didn't want to do it. So finally I wrote a duet, and I had them where they had to come in and sing on the same mic together. And they started singing, and like in the first six bars of the music, they were just like, wow, these voices blend together so good. And it was a girl named Trisha Yearwood. So Garth really was blown away by her voice, and helped her get a record deal and all that stuff. And then, I don't know, what was it, 10, 15 years later, they ended up falling in love and getting married. And so there's an ex-wife somewhere that's probably not real happy with me. I just wanted to get two great singers together. So Garth, about the time that they were starting their relationship, he wanted to write a song about it. He called me up and said, we'll get together and write a song about it, Trisha and I. And I said, well, of course we can. And so we wrote this thing, and Cory's going to help me out on it. And I think it was on the Scarecrow album. Is that right? Cory knows more about me than I do, but that's all right, too. So this is Garth about Trisha.
Oh, it's a day we've never tried to get by.